Next, let's look at crankcase ventilation, or CCV. These are often referred to as the crankcase breather system because I guess it's seen as the engine breathing out its excess gas that escapes past the cylinders during combustion and enters the crankcase. This gas needs to be vented to prevent pressure building up in the crankcase, which would eventually try to escape past the oil seals or gaskets. This is often why, if a CCV system is blocked, we often see engine oil leaks develop. Crankcase ventilation is regarded as an emission, so correct CCV design and servicing is essential to ensure emission standards are met. CCV design can vary depending on engine type, the application where it's installed, and the country where it will operate. Let's look at some different examples of CCV on our engines here in the learning centre. On this 1100 series, we can see the most basic type of CCV. The crankcase breather exits the engine via a gauze filter in the valve cover and exits via a hose down the side of the engine. This is known as open circuit CCV. On this engine, the crankcase is vented directly into the air intake, so recirculated through the combustion system. This is known as a closed circuit CCV. Even on the most basic design, we can find a filter that will need to be cleaned or replaced in line with the service interval. On this 1204 series, we'll find a filter inside this canister. You'll also notice on this design how the canister also serves as a separator. Gases are routed through the filter before exiting, while any excess fluids route back into the engine oil system. So this is a filtered open circuit CCV. So these are some of the examples you might come across. For specific information on servicing your CCV, refer to the appropriate operation and maintenance manual.